HPI guys, Model Workshop coming at you again with another submarine review. I've been on a little submarine kick ever since I got to tour the Wisconsin Maritime Museum and spend a nice long tour going through the USS Cobia front to back. That's an old World War II submarine that I talked about in my SS Gato Lindbergh model review. This is the Revell German submarine U-boot type 7C. This is 1/350th scale. That means this model will come out to about 8 inches long. And if that sounds tiny, it is. So let's take some of the look at some of the parts trees here. This is one of the hull halves. You can see there's a man's hand. And you can see on the measurement board here, that's not big at all. That's pretty tiny. Okay, what really is going to make you get a little flustered when you start building this is that the hull is not only these two pieces, which are beautifully engraved, you can see up close, and you'll end up sanding a little of those lines down as you build it and paint it. You won't see them as strongly. So they're there. Beautiful engraving on something so small. You can see the anchor there. When you start assembling this, these two parts of the hull, let's get these lined up here. These two parts of the hull will go together like so. And they don't touch on the top, as you can see. What happens is this tiny sliver of a piece that you can see that was warped coming out of the mold, see that bend? That bend goes all the way through. That actually is supposed to be placed on the top here once you cut it out of the parts trees. This looks very finicky. That's why after taking this kit apart and out of the box, I do not recommend this kit for a beginner. I recommend this kit for someone who has a good amount of modeling experience under their belt. If you don't have a lot of experience, if you're not used to it, these three parts will probably give you fits getting them together, getting the two hull sides together, getting the top on, getting the top deck on. Now let's take a look at the detail on that top deck as well. Beautiful engraving on this teeny tiny kit. And the thing's knife point sharp. But this is definitely not for the beginner. So don't even think about it. If you've never built a ship before, if you've never built a model before, or if you have some kids bugging you for something to do, this isn't the right kit for them. The kit is inexpensive, which might lead you to believe you should grab it. These are under $8 on any online shop. That's why when you get it, you see the size of the box, you go, holy cow. Let's look at some of the other parts on the trees. This right here, this tiny, tiny part here, is your cable cutter. That's that part right there. That's so that they couldn't drop cables or nets into the water and catch the submarines on them. One of the few part trees that are included, you can see part of the conning tower, the structure of the top of the submarine, some of the railings. If you've watched my SS Gato review of the Lindbergh kit, which was twice the size of this, that kit did not have the super fine detail that this Revell kit does. It did not have all these tiny little antenna extensions and cabling areas. It certainly didn't have that level of engraving on the upper hull on the conning tower. The final parts tree of this kit, you could see some more antennas, periscopes. You can see those on there. And this right here, this is your stand. So you can imagine how small that thing is going to be. Your decal sheet is here. And the largest decals you see on there, the U designations where it says U-boot type 7C, these are actually for the stand. They don't go on the submarine. All you're going to be using on the submarine is this tiny German flag. And these insignias here, depending on which submarine you put together. That's it. There isn't really an extensive amount of parts, but it is a high parts count for something that's only 8 inches long and that tiny. That right there is all the plastic you get in the kit for the $8. The instructions, pretty straightforward what you'd expect. It shows you how to put the two hull pieces together, how to put the top deck on, then how to attach it to the base and start assembling the small parts. You can see them there. And then they will give you the rest of the directions on the back with an idea of how to put it together and how to decal it. I think it's a nice kit if you have experience with models. Like I said, I do not recommend this for someone who has no experience, and I certainly don't recommend this for children because it's just going to end up with parts all over. None of them are going to make it onto the kit. Something on here I wanted to show you, if we can get it to focus. If you look right in the center, those are the propellers, and you have to try to grab those. I mean, look at the size of your finger in the propellers. So this is definitely, a lot of this work is going to be done with a pair of tweezers. But if you like submarines, and if you like a challenge, and you have some kits underneath your belt, pick it up for less than $8 and give it a try. Just don't blame me if you end up with small parts all over the place and throw this thing right in the garbage, because it is tiny. HPI Guys Model Workshop. Have a great day.